Hey everybody, welcome back. How's it going, EDC Life? Sorry about the delay there. Had a weird little bit of delay going with my live stream for some reason. Anyways, we got it up and running. Bunzo. What's up, Hilltop? What's up, Paul? Got the water going in the background. What's up, Penny? Gear the Gorge. What's up, buddy? It has been a while. Drake's, Spirited, Dane, Ty Addiction. What's up? Daniel's here. Nasty Renegade. I'm doing good, man. Doing good. This is going to be an interesting live stream, so bear with me. What's up, Steven? What's up, C. Lemansky? R. Campbell? Yeah, definitely. We need more Gear the Gorge videos. Oh, nice deep blue. Right on. So, we got about 18 people on right now. What's up, Victor? So, while I'm doing the work over here, I won't be able to respond to your questions. And I don't think I can zoom in at all. I can zoom in a little bit here. But I do have lots of stuff here ready to go. What's up, Rhino? So I won't be able to see your questions until I pull up my other monitor. So give me a second on that. Tips for finding discontinued. Yeah, there's a couple forums and stuff we can talk about. Some people might be able to post them here. Pull up my other monitor so I can see your guys's. Awesome. What's up, Slick Slicers? All right, there we go. So I think I got the other monitor going. Hopefully you guys can hear me okay. I know some of you guys are over with Patty Potato Peeler, so that's cool. That's cool. But just so you know, the winner of our poll between these two Rit Dyes was Purple. Purple was the winner. So... Purple. Oh, Patty sent you? That's so nice of him. I give some more love to Patty, man. Patty's awesome. So Purple was the winner. So we'll shake this up, get it ready to go. It's awesome stuff. Haven't done one live like this before, so bear with me. But we do have a couple things. We have our 4 cups of water, bringing it to a rolling boil. We have our mini bug out. I'm gonna take that apart in just a second. We have, let's see what else we got here. Some shadows, but that's okay. Let's see here. We have our 1/4 cup of vinegar. So I'm waiting to put that in, but that's gonna go inside. I have a dish here with soapy water. So we're gonna rinse the scales off in that. And then we're gonna put them in some water, which is in this one. I'm trying to show you guys everything that I'll do over here. And then I have another clear one of water over here that I'll use once we get rolling. So anyways, Patty, what's up, man? That's so nice of you. Man, I'm gonna try to do this quick so I can let Patty get back. Now this is rolling to a boil, so I'm gonna take that off really quick. Because you guys wanted to see the disassembly. So I'm going to do the disassembly really quick here on the mini bug out. So I'm using a Torx bit, a T6. Most Benchmades have that going. What's up, Chris? Oh, Patty, that's so nice of you, man. I saw all your blue knives going. And you can see right here, you get a little bit of dirt underneath there. So we'll wash that off here in a second. So that's the trouble with the white one, but it cleans off really good. What's up, Big Red? What's up, Ohio? Nasty Renegades here. Just gonna put all these in here. This nice little mat that I got has some heat resistance, as well as, it's It's good for electronic parts. Now this should take rather quickly once we get it going in there. But the important thing is take your knife apart and then you need to clean it and kind of degrease it. So that's what the bowl of Dawn soap. I don't, hopefully I can say that one without getting in trouble. But let's just say it's a degreaser dishwashing soap. We'll put the pivot in there. We're using a T10 on that one. Shout out to Weehaw. Let's take the other side off. So we got one side completely off. We got all the screws removed. We got the pivot, the male side of the pivot on that one out. And if you hear any whistling or howling, we have a crazy windstorm out here in the Pacific Northwest today. And it's nice and sunny and like 34 degrees out. So, just weird weather. Guess it matches everything else. What's up, Steven? Oh, you're getting wind there too? Yeah, I don't get it, but whatever. Just making for an interesting day. I'll take the wind over the ice. We had ice this morning. So, okay. So, we're getting our last screw out here. We'll go ahead and pop these scales off. They're like glued on there. Do it without getting myself. Let me pop this pivot out. Backside. So the question will be, can we get it back together? This is too funny. So we got the blade out. You see the washers. So we'll put that off to the side. I must have put a lot of glue on these. These barrel spacers in the back, because it's sticking pretty good. There we go. Really sticking on that back one. There we go. Yeah, you can see the white chalkiness that's on that screw is all the blue Loctite that spilled over. So we'll try to push this other side out. There we go. I was like, man, I've never had a problem taking those barrel spacers out, but yeah, exactly. So anyway, so here's all the internal parts of your mini bug out. Hopefully you can see all those. Put those up there. And then here's your inside of your scales. And you can see kind of the dirt that collects with the oil and whatnot. Get the right light for you. There you go. So we're gonna give these a cleaning. Get my handy dandy soap suds with my degreaser stuff in here. So we'll drop those in there. And we're gonna give them a little wash really quick. Get them all degreased, get them all cleaned up. Now this is something that I generally do. What's up, Morgan? This is something I generally do under the sink. Makes it a little easier, but instead of bringing you guys back and forth, I figured, well, let's just do it right here. Let's do it all right here. Bring you guys along for the journey. So obviously the degreaser part is so the dye will stick to all your FRN plastic. So I'm just scrubbing those with my washcloth, getting those nice and clean. Because I want that dye to stick everywhere, especially around your pivot, your barrel spacers and all that. So I'm gonna rinse one of them over here. We'll let that dry for a second. And I'll get the second one going. What's up, Earl? Just so you guys know, purple one. as you can see in the background. What's up, Rodney? So we're just getting these, the second set of the scale cleaned off and degreased in my bowl of degreaser detergent, commonly found. Well, not anymore commonly found at the grocery store, but you know what I'm saying. What's up, Garacore EDC? So we got that going. I think those are both good. So we'll go ahead and rinse this one off also. I normally run them under the sink for about 30 seconds. But since we don't have that ability, we'll put them on here. Make sure all the soap's off. Okay. Rinse my hands off. We'll dry my hands. Get that going. Now, we'll put my water back on the heat. We're gonna bring this to a rolling boil. Recipe is 4 cups of water and 1/4 cup of distilled white vinegar. We'll put that in, give it a little mix. Set this off to the side. Feel like some sort of show here for cooking. So we'll knock the water off, but you can see that got all cleaned up. I could probably do a little bit better job if I scrubbed it, maybe with a dish brush. But the good old microfiber towels, those work out really well. So we'll get this one dried off. Not to the point of it really matters if it's wet, but just making sure all the soap's off there, any leftover deposits of grease, or on this one, blue Loctite. What are you guys up to today? Anything fun? Hey now, Steven, what's up with that? Haha, Dane. Like, hey, I think you guys should go to the store. Don't worry about your pot. I won't use your pot for anything like Rit Dye. So we got those dried off. I got all the extra dirt and grease off of them. I will clean off also the little bit of water that's on here. One of the things that I choose to use is a steel skewer that we've got from, you know, doing some barbecues. So I end up putting the scales back to back, and I use the access lock hole to put them in there like this. So that's my idea. I put them in that way, but we're gonna wait. The water's almost up to a rolling boil. So when that happens, we'll add the purple Rit Dye, which I'll do about half a bottle. Yeah, B-Boy, Kid Combo 1 asked, will the blue factory scales dye black? Yes, they will. They do a good job with that. You can use a dark blue or you can use black, and they work out great. Oh, you got some, Morgan got some carnitas tacos? Dang, man. Oh, and you're fixing a friend's shocks. Oh, hood shocks, that's nice of you. Fire medics here. New sharpening compound? Oh, right on. Yeah, I'm getting a lot of stuff done being home today. So far, I'm back to work tomorrow. Now, one of the important things for me when we do the dye is just some of your regular disposable gloves. I had to get a lot of these out of my supplies because you can't order them anymore. So it seems. Maybe in a few months we'll have stock again and everything. Let's see. So we got the gloves on. Ready to go. Yeah, what's in everyone's pocket? Now this one has a little like sealed thing on top. So you get that nice purple color shining through. So those are the things. Put that on the towel over here. Paper towel, don't tell anybody. Chad's all about the nines, huh? The nines. Oh, I got the Buck Spitfire. Nice. G10 Bugout. Cool. All right. I guess I took my water off for a little too long. It's almost there. There we go. Getting some rolling boil now. So let's add the dye. About half the bottle. Could go a little less, but what's the point? Now, I'm gonna time this. We're at about 2:16 p.m. Shouldn't take very long at all. And then we'll go to the water over here. Try to get this the right color. So here we are. Last time we'll see the white scales going into the purple brew. I usually use them to stir it up a little bit. What do you think so far? I mean, that was quick. What was that? 15, 30 seconds? Let me use the paper towels, I'll show you. Yeah, the rinse is just cold water, that's all. What do you think so far? Might go a little bit more, but not too much. I mean, fast. Yeah, like I said, that vinegar helps. It just helps hit it. I think I'm good. Yeah, I think so. Okay. There's my purple color. The nice part is if they truly are too light, I can throw them back in. But I'm gonna use this paper towel, dab off some of this extra dye. Only because I'm going to use the bucket of water here. And you can kind of see what comes off of it here in just a second. So this is just cold water. I should move this one because this is giving a little bit of blue to it. And let's take this off. Hold on here. I'm that guy, you know. Leave something on the burner. I don't know if you can see this one very well. But this is just for rinsing. Yeah, Stormtrooper is nice. So, let me take them off here. I'm gonna have to wash so many dishes tonight. Okay. So we're gonna put them on here, get them dried off. What I usually do is I will let them air dry for a little while because you have all these little holes in here where you get some Q-tips and get a lot of that going. But I'll put it back together right now. We should be pretty good anyways. What's up, Amos? There is some ways to do it, but I haven't seen too many ways of how they undye stuff. But I think it turned out pretty good, purple-wise. Now, one thing I will show you is the difference between the purples when you're using a different base color. So, this one was dyed purple using a tan. And it's hard in this light to show you, but this was dyed purple using a tan GRY-1 Bugout. And this was dyed purple using the white one. So you can see that purple pops a lot more. And I'll do some pictures with it, but the kitchen lighting's not the greatest here. So yeah. So let's put this back together really quick. We'll see how it goes here. Get our T6. Guess I could take the gloves off now. But that's half the fun, right? So I might have another project I'm doing that I'll reuse the dye for. I've never saved it like in a bottle or a jar or anything, but you could probably do that. I just don't know what the impact would be with the vinegar. But I do have another project I'll use it for. Yeah, certain people do. You know, I try to line all my stuff up if I'm doing a certain, you know, style of, you know, dyeing. Like if I'm like, hey, I'm going to do a bunch of stuff in purple, then I'm going to go ahead and just do it all at the same time. Yeah, it works really well using white. So I'm just putting in the male side of the pivot. I know there's a trick or an actual tool that aids, that helps with putting Benchmades back together. And I'm actually trying to see if someone will make that readily available for everyone. Hee hee hee. Oh, okay. Nice, B-boy. Yeah, you could use it for all sorts of stuff. B-Boy was talking about using it for dyeing skateboard wheels. Okay, OCD for EDC, Justin. He said it'll keep for a few weeks. Somebody's talking about finding a 3D print for the backspacer. I'm not sure. I haven't messed around with a 3D printer at all. So I'm not sure who would be hosting that. I know there's people that make that stuff. I'm doing like most of it off screen. Sorry about that, guys. Here, let me show you. Sorry about that. My apologies. I'm not used to working over the stove with the knife. A knife build, I should say. For me, it's always funny building it. Hey, Big Red, thanks, man. I appreciate that. Much appreciated. The red fade would look nice. Look really nice. So I'm gonna put these barrel spacers back in. They do have a flat portion, so they won't spin. So you just have to get that lined up. Almost have to get my magnifying glass out. Mini version makes everything so much smaller. That second one in. So are any of you guys off work for the week? Or taking time off for the week on purpose? Feared I'd ask. How many have I reassembled? Probably a couple dozen at least of my own. I'm missing my one favorite tool, though. That's why I'm like, one day I'll have one. I just hope they offer it to everyone. There's just no little alignment tool. But, side note, doing this to your mini Bugout will void your LifeSharp warranty Sorry, I had to say that. But honestly, they're not super crazy about it. I mean, most of the people like the mods on knives, but they could technically say you damaged something if you took it apart, strip screws out, something like that. But they've been pretty cool about taking care of it. Steven, you've been off work for that long? Wow. Okay. Hopefully you get some work soon if that's what you're looking for. Now there is a D portion to this pivot. So it does have a flat spot. I took it out to show you. And it does go facing up towards the access lock. And I just use the bigger bits to line it up and then push it through with my other finger. I do pull it back a little bit on the access bar. Oh, you gotta go back to work, Rodney? Yeah. Same here, same here. I'm ready. I've had a day off. Today's my day off. Spend it with you guys. Looking at some sweet knives. Talking to you guys. Oh, the schools are all closed down. Oh, that's cool. Nice. So I got the pivot almost all the way through. As you can see, it's taking shape pretty nice. I'm going to get a couple more of the screws on. The last few. And I will take this apart and put the blue Loctite back on these screws. Just so they will hold together. Especially with it being so small and the only a couple threads holding each one in. Alright. Okay. Take my T10. Put my male side pivot back together. So I like to screw them all the way down, the pivots. I mean, not so they're crazy, but like right now I can't open it, so it'd be perfect for like shipping it to Canada. And then back it out a little bit. It's got some good action to it. Put the pocket clip back on. It's got these two little screws here. Use my T6 again for those. Oh, thanks, Nick. I appreciate that. Appreciate you joining us again. All right. So we're going to give this thing a little whirl. We're going to see how it all goes. Sorry about not doing it on camera again. All right, here we go. I'll probably tighten that pivot up a little bit. It does fall shut pretty good. But what do you guys think about this purple dye? Try to get some good light on it. Yeah, I like it. So you guys voted. The final tally right before I started on Instagram was 75% to 25%. Can you buy it? I don't know, Nick. Shoot me a message. I can make another one. But let's do something crazy. Let's compare it to the original. And I know I'm getting a little bit of reflection here, so trying to work with the best light. Maybe I'll do it this way. A little bit better. So, I like the Stormtrooper version. I am a fan of the purple, however. The purple dye looks really good. And here's purple that's on a GRY-1. So hopefully you can see the contrast between the blade. The mini bug out has the black blade. The full size bug out has the GRY-1, kind of the nitride coated blade. And then you can see the difference in the purple, how it took. Same exact dye, same exact method and time frame. And this, the mini on top is so much lighter. So the purple is so much richer. So anyways, and of course I put a backspacer on mine from Rock Scale Design on the big one, the black one, and put the black thumb studs on it. But yeah, so anyways, that is the quick rundown, the live version. Do you guys have any questions now that I can read your comments? I have two. 60% Benchmade, yeah. Yeah, I know, I need to cook dinner now. I need to set that up way different. Hamburger helper, yeah. I like them. I think they both turned out great, so. I think the second quarter of the year, so there's two knives left. So they've been doing like releases every quarter. And there's two knives left. The first one's going to be the Tengu Flipper. And the second one's going to be the Mini Presidio 2. After that, I can see a lot of knives coming out, maybe variations, probably a couple new ones, and then variations of ones that are already out there. I really hope there's going to be a new Freak, a G10 one, or Carbon Fiber maybe CF Elite. That'd be kind of cool too. So, yeah, so that's what I think is going on. I don't think it'll work on carbon fiber. I haven't tried it, but I think the way that it works, it won't dye the carbon fiber like that. Yeah, Randy, right on, buddy. A mini Freak in G10. That's what I'm really hoping for in the second quarter. You smell a knife sale? Let me know, man. I got knives right here. I got the dye, so I can throw another one in the batch, you know? Take it apart. But I really like the way that one turned out. Yeah, okay, Taz is confirming you can't dye the carbon fiber. I didn't think so, because it probably would have been done several times. I like the way how they mix it, though, how they can weave it with some G10 and stuff. Oh, yeah, Thomas, a yellow mini would be cool. $100 for it. Oh, Hilltop, thanks, man. Appreciate that. Fist bump, baby, fist bump. Yeah, so hopefully this comes across the camera. But for me, I love it. Hype it up. And I think I also just got notification. I don't know if you saw one of my other live streams before. I just got notification that the Timascus backspacer for the bug out, so one of these backspacers from Rock Scale Design, but it's in Timascus, is headed my way. So I'm pumped about that. So thanks, Bunzo. Well, it's not too shabby. It took me about 30 minutes to break it down, do all that. I think if I wasn't doing, you know, if I was just using the sink, walking back and forth really quick, wasn't using different buckets and wasn't trying to talk during the whole time, it'd probably work a lot better. It'd probably take you about 20 minutes to break it down, put it back together. Oh, nice. Joshua, you got a Norseman coming. That's cool. And also, just for comparison, Thanks, Penny. There's the mini orange one. And there's the white one. So, kind of got it all labeled in together. But yeah. Thanks, C. Lemansky. You guys have any other questions for me? I might wrap this up just because I know like Slicey Dicey's got something coming. OCD for EDC's got something coming tonight. Nick, thanks, man. Number one fan. Number one fan's going to try to be buying that mini Bugout, I think. Yeah, it turned out great. I saw, so a couple people have already done the purple and the red. And I've seen a couple people do it. And so, all right, Joshua, see you later. Just so you know, this is a tan GRY-1 Bugout dyed racing red, synthetic racing red. So, trade TP for it. Yeah, exactly. Yeah, it's all good, EDC Life. Yeah, just send me a message on Instagram. So this is one. You can see that it has all the stock, you know, barrel spacers and thumb stud. But it turned out pretty good. Yeah, it's a deep red. And so I think if there was a white one in the full size, it would come out a lot brighter, kind of, you know, in contrast to that purple there. But the red works really good. This is a tan FRN scale at the beginning. I am not an investment banker. I should be, though. Well, I mean, if you count Bugouts, maybe that's my investment purchase. Yeah, it is almost like a maroon. And I don't think I have anything red that would be, well, I mean, I guess you can compare it to the red on here. So that's your kind of standard red on the label. And then that's your maroon red there. So yeah. So it all just depends on what your starting color is. Nice. So yeah, so you know, check out the other channels going live today. I really appreciate all your guys' support. There's like over 50 of you guys right now. And it's just one of those things where it's like, holy cow, you guys are awesome. Yeah, you can do all sorts of things to anodizing, definitely. You can change colors on anodizing and stuff. But there's also ways to, you know, work with it. You know, you saw the bailout, how they did the green in that. And it's a whole process. But I probably don't have everything here to do that. And I wouldn't be able to dye them. Can I talk about the new bailout? It's in the other room. No, I don't. Nick, I don't think Rit Dye will work on the aluminum. Que pasa, CK? What's up? Yeah, we just finished up dyeing some scales on this mini Bugout. We went from white to a purple. So I think it went pretty good. So, yeah. All right, you guys. Well, you guys stay safe out there. Take care of each other. If you guys have anything, send me a message. Send me an email. Try to be involved as I can with you guys. Work's been crazy the last few weeks, so that's why videos have been a little sparse for the last week and a half. But you guys will be getting some good content. It was super fun doing this today. I kind of like this. I think I need to do a little bit different setup. So I might get a bigger tripod. Right now I'm using one that's on a countertop. So kind of works like that. So Big Red, take care. And yeah, you guys do something kind this week. Make sure to share the TP and everything because we all appreciate that. And yeah. Oh yeah, OCD for EDC does a lot of anodizing. So thanks, Penny. I appreciate it. You guys have an awesome night and I'll see you on the next one. Take care, everybody.